Hey guys, what's going on? GC Dunkaroo. We are getting ready to play the qualifying round of the Paradise Islands tournament. This is going to be in the Pro Division. It's just kind of a hack around. We're going to play Pro, like I said. We'll use just Power 1 balls, so Kassars and Navigators, and see if we can't put together a decent score. I may time out on some shots trying to show you guys some things or things like that. This is more for learning than really like copying shots. We'll see if what we do works. But I'm not trying to post a score today. Just trying to teach you guys a little bit, give you some information about the course and ways I'd play shots, and kind of take it from there. So I'm gonna set up my bag real quick. Power one on our pro account, and so I'm gonna be. I think I'm going to switch out of the Falcon because a lot of people don't have Falcon 4. And I'll switch over to. Let's do that real quick. I'm going to switch over to the Thorn 7. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to try to play this entire round with a rock or extra mile. I don't know if everybody has an APOC. I've also got a Thor's Hammer as well, but I think the best way to teach people is to kind of show clubs that they might have. Most people already have a extra mile. It could be like a level 5, level 6, level 7. So I'll show you that. And hopefully we can do well with this setup right here, which is extra mile, sniper, grizzly. I'm just not a fan of playing with the Goliath guys, so I'm gonna play with the grizzly, just to kind of help out with the ball guide a little bit. And then I've got the rapier and Arana and the Malibu in there. So, all right, hole one, let's get started. Alright, so at first, so 8.5 is the wind. You can kind of see there our driver goes a little bit into the rough if we do the if we go overpower. So we're just gonna back out a little bit. You can kind of see the ball guy gets over the top there. I'm gonna put the yellow ring right on the line there, and then I'm gonna play 20% elevation change. So 8.5 is gonna be 4.9 rings. So whenever it's 4.9, I always just go back 5. And then I'm going to put full curl on this. And we did go great left, which is going to be okay. It should be able to bounce over the bunker and kind of roll out nice right there in front of the bushes there. So if you don't have an extra mile 7, you might play with a quarterback, and just play a little bit further to the left with a little more curl on it, to get over that to get over that rough patch there. It's okay if you hit the rough and roll out into the fairway. You just don't want to hit the excuse me, you don't want to hit the bunker there. All right, so for the second shot, I'm gonna try minus 5%. I'm gonna figure out where we're at in our club. Looks like we're with the Grizzly, so 6.0 is gonna be 6.1, 5.2, or 4.3. And it looks like we can play it really right at min distance, which is gonna be 4.3. So I'm just gonna scoot this up just a little bit and then put some backspin on it. And put the ball guide right at the hole. And then I'm going to go 4.3. Let's see how this turns out. Hit great right, so we'll see if it ends up just right of the hole. Would have been close. I think I'd recommend, just based on where the ball landed, that you do a 0% elevation shot, and kind of find out where you're at in your club. So 0% on the second shot on the first hole, and 20% elevation on the drive. All right, so hole number two is going to be a par three, and we're going to play with a navigator because we don't need a lot of side spin, and then we're going to play with the sniper. Okay, so I'm going to try this at 25%. Let's see there, 25. 5.5 is our win. And Sniper 10 is a little different than every other sniper. I'm going to play full backspin. And we're kind of like 80% of the club. So 25% at 80%. It's going to be 6.5 rings. And I'm just going to line up with the ball guide kind of at the hole there. And then go 6.5 rings. Let's see how close this shot gets. A little long. So I think in 20% instead of 25%, 20% would be 6.2. So I'm going to try 20% when I play my round tomorrow. Right, so hole three, we're going to play with the bag setup that we talked about, and then the Kasar. You might also, if you're not too concerned with trying to make Albatross, you might switch woods, maybe to like a big dog or something with a little more distance than 172 yards, because this is a really, really long par five. And if you're gonna play it with if you're gonna play it with a wood that's a sniper, then in a power one ball, you may have a little trouble getting all the way to the green. All right, so I'm gonna play this at 10%, which is gonna be 7.3, which is gonna be 3.8 rings. And this is a shot that we're gonna put full top and three left, and then we're gonna go with basically adjust the 3.8 rings, and then you're gonna push up to max. And then I always just put a slight amount of overpower and about a quarter ball of curl on it. And we did hit great left. Hopefully that's not going to affect it too much. Looks like it's going to bounce, and then you want that secondary bounce. And we did just roll into the fairway there. It's definitely a shot with a power one ball that you could use some overpower with. But that is a safe shot onto there. And because we have a tailwind right now, we're going to have a tailwind going into the green, which is going to make the chance for Albatross a lot easier. Okay, for the second shot, it's going to be 20% downhill. So 20% downhill. We have 7.5, which is going to be 8.9. So I'm going to go full top. And you can kind of see that at full overpower, we can just barely get there. So if I adjust 8.9 rings and then I push up, we're still going to need to give it just a little bit of overpower as well. Hit the great right, should be okay though. It's just not going to go in the hole for Albatross. and a lot of shots are going to end up in this chipping area here. So I will show you the easiest way to chip this. Normally I don't show the shots around the green, but I think that there's a benefit to this because a lot of people will get into this position. Okay, so this is a chip that everybody's going to get commonly. Move your target around till the guide drops off like that. And then you really don't have to adjust at all. I'm playing with a Rapier 6, so you could, if you wanted to, add some topspin, move the guide back a little bit, but really, it's really that such a short distance. I mean, we're only talking about a couple yards. So as long as you have the ball guide through the hole, it's going to make it so that you have a big amount of space to make the shot. So again, don't extend your ball guide. It's such a relatively short shot that you can just play it pretty straight in. All right, hole four. Hole four is a tricky par three. Hopefully, we can do this well. We're gonna play it with a sniper and a navigator ball. Depending on the wind, we might have to show a couple different things. It's gonna be a 15% elevation change. All right, so at first, so 7.3 is the wind, so that's 8.3 at max. You can kind of see that we are right at max distance. So I like to drop back here and then use some tailwind. So that's basically a 1-to-1 shot, 7.4. Let's see how this turns out. So mid distance, 15%, kind of play in that second, at that second, excuse me, at the first landing area. Let the ball bounce to the second one and then slide into the hole. The nice part about this shot is that because it's just a crosswind, you don't have too much of an issue with the ball shooting on you, as it would with a, excuse me, with a more, tailwind or headwind shot. All right, so for hole five, we're gonna play with the extra mile, and a Kassar ball. Gonna be a 10% elevation change on the drive, and depending on the wind will pretty much dictate whether you go left or right. All right, so at first we have a tailwind, so I'm actually gonna play it at 15%, which will help adjust for the secondary bounce. So that's 3.5 rings. So we're gonna be up here at max, and we're gonna go full left and full top. And then I really just want to adjust right about here. And 3.5 is the adjustment. And then I'm just gonna put just a slight amount of curl on it. Maybe like a quarter ball, quarter to a half. We probably could have moved the target a little bit more to the right, and used a little more curl just to keep it away from those trees. We'll see what kind of shot we have coming in. All right, so second shot is going to be zero elevation. We're going to play with the Grizzly at 6.7. And so we're just here at min distance. And I'm going to play with one right spin and then just enough top spin to get it to the hole. So really we don't have to use much top spin at all. And then 6.7 is going to be 5.1. Then we'll take our shot. Ooh, we hit a little speed bump there. It's okay though. It'll still. You will hit that from time to time, but you'll still have the ability to chip from there. Alright, so for hole six, I'm going to play. Need to buy another pack of Kassars. We're going to play with the Kassar with the extra mile, and it's going to be a 20% elevation change. And we're going to play with the Sniper as well. You're definitely more than welcome to play with a different club if you'd like. It is a shot that that second shot is really hard. So having a decent having a decent club is critical. So we're going to play up here at the top, full right. You kind of want that ball guide right there in the center of the fairway. And then 6.3 at 20% is going to be 3.6. And no overpower and no curl. So 367 is the number right there, and that should set us up with a good chance for even an albatross on this hole. Alright, so second shot is going to be 0% elevation, 0%, 7.2 is the wind, so it's going to be 7.1 at max. You can kind of see how we're right here on the edge at max distance. I'm going to back this up just a little bit because of the tailwind. And I'm going to play one ball of right spin and three bars of backspin. And then 7.1. And we hit it perfect. Let's see what happens. Just barely missed. So definitely with a power one ball and a good drive with the sniper or with the extra mile or something like that, there's definitely a chance to make the hole in one on this hole. It looks like because of that fall off going downhill from the bounce to the green that you might want to even offset your shot a little bit to the left of the pin, just because of the fact that the downhill will kind of shoot the ball a little bit, and so that might help it out to slow down a little more. All right, hole seven is the only par three that I'm going to use a Kassar ball on, and the reason is because of the side spin. I'm going to show you guys where to set up to be able to get birdie every time. And then kind of how to do the curl as well. And we'll, based on the wind, we'll adjust a little bit. But I'll show you guys here in a second. So Sniper and Kassar. And I'm going to play this at 10% at mid distance. Mid. You can definitely play with the Guardian if you want to put backspin on the ball to get it towards the green. There are other ways to play this shot off of the rough line. But, you know, if you're just trying to get birdies and try to be successful and not go in the rough and things like that, then this is going to be the way to play. Okay, so 10% elevation. Like I said, we're gonna play at mid distance. 7.6 is the wind, so that's 7.3 rings. So basically, you're gonna go full left, and then what is that? 6 bars of topspin or backspin. And I always aim this kind of right with the same line with the blue ring half in the rough over here. And kind of on the same line there. So 7.3. And then we're gonna go just outside of this triangle. And you'll see that with a little bit of tweaking, that comes in really nice, right into the green. So 6 bars of backspin. If you don't have 6 bars of backspin, you're gonna have to adjust a little bit, maybe go a little shorter, and don't put as much curl on it, to be able to get it to stop. Right, so hole eight, we're gonna play one of two ways. I'm hoping we can play to the right side, and I'm gonna use the rock. But if we can't, then we'll play to the left side with the extra mile. And we're going to use a guitar ball. All right, so 10% elevation change. Trying to decide which way I want to go. I think we'll go to the right. So I used the Kassar so we could get as much topspin. So I'm basically going to try to play the shot right here. So 7.1 at 10%. It's gonna be 8.1. Excuse me. 7.6. And then we're going to put about a full ball of curl on it. And then that's going to feed down nicely. You want to be kind of in that shaded area, and that's going to give you the best chance of a sniper shot, even possibly for an eagle on this shot, on this hole. All right, so second shot elevation. I'm not sure of what exactly the elevation is, but just kind of looking at it and kind of taking a view from here, I'd say it's probably about 30%. So we're going to try that. So I'm going to go full left spin, put some backspin on it. And we're kind of at max distance. So 30% is going to be 7.7. I don't think we're going to get this shot off. That's okay. So I'm going to time out here now that I showed you everything. And then we're going to try that same shot again in just a second here. All right, we'll try the shot again. 30% elevation, and this time we have a 6.9 wind, so it's gonna be 8.8. So full left. We're gonna go up to max, which is gonna be there. I'm gonna leave this just short. So 8.8. Let's see how that shot turns out. Pretty nice. So, I would say it's not 30. It's probably, I might try 20 next time. And see how that turns out. Alright, hole 9. We're going to play with the extra mile and a navigator. Hopefully with a little bit of a tailwind. You don't need a lot of side spin on this hole, but you do need precision in terms of the wind. So that's why I decided to play with navigator as opposed to the Kasar. So it's going to be a 10% elevation change. And like I said, we're going to play with the extra mile. We're up first, 7.4 is the wind. So I'm basically going to go four top and all the left spin. And you can kind of see that I need to push up about one ring. So 7.4 at 10% is going to be 3.9. And then I'm going to push up about one ring. We did hit great left. Might put us in a little bit of trouble here. But I did put a tiny bit of curl on it. Nope. Dang it. Sorry, guys. I would put just a slight amount of curl on it. I definitely rushed that a little bit. I probably should have taken it back. But four top spin is the key. You can use a Kasar ball to get a little more left spin on that, and that might have helped us there. You can definitely use an APOC like our opponent's using. But just remember, four top spin is max, because you can go into that rough that's over there by the palm trees as well. You can see there our opponent did go into that rough just by using full topspin. I'm just going to chip this out so I can show you what the second shot looks like. Alright, so I played this shot 15% downhill. And 5.2 is our wind, so it's going to be 5.9 with a sniper. And I always use as much right spin as possible. It'll keep you out of this area here. In this case, I probably only need to use one bar. And you always want to leave the ball guide short of the hole, because you have that tailwind. So then 5.9. And let's see how this turns out. Just missed. Like I said, 15% elevation is definitely the right number. We probably could have backed that ball up just a little bit to try to keep it from staying off to the right hand side. Alright, so this was my pro walkthrough with playing with a Power 1 ball in the pro tournament. You can see that based on the way we played with all the shots that we took, we would have shot a minus 12 there without any drops. Minus 12 in pro will definitely get you into the opening round, and may even be enough to get you into the qualifying round as well. So that is with a Power 1 ball. You're certainly more than welcome to use a Power 2, Power 3 ball, or even higher than that in a couple of cases. I definitely saw that on hole number 8, where we used the rock, if you had a Berserker ball, you could definitely overpower that shot and end up with maybe a nice little short iron into the green as well at a 0% or 5% elevation change. So just a couple of thoughts. Thanks for watching the video. Let me know if you have any questions, or maybe let me know a different way that you're playing a hole. And we can see if we can tweak it to get you the drop. All right, I will be probably doing a qualifying round for both pro and expert tomorrow night. Gonna hack around on expert here in a few, and then we will hopefully qualify all the accounts for the opening round and catch up later on this week. Thanks guys for watching, and we'll see you next time.